Hello guys, welcome back to Custom Gamer. My name is Daz and this is the show where we talk about level design while playing cool maps. This week we're going to be playing through Spherical Nightmares by David Lundvall, aka WizardX. This was a mod that was released about a month ago, perhaps a little bit less. I don't know, I've kind of lost track of time these days. It's a fairly interesting mod to have a look at because it does some things really, really well and other things not quite as well as it could have done. So let's have a look, shall we?
Rise and shine, Mr. Freeman. Rise and shine.
All right, and off we go. So yeah, it's got a fairly in-depth intro. A lot of exposition at the start there. Now, this is something that's probably the first topic worth mentioning about this mod is that the story is very kind of front-loaded in this mod. The first kind of hour, I suppose you could say, has got some fairly lengthy story exposition and various kind of story sequences in the maps, and that kind of drops off almost completely after, like I say, about the first hour of gameplay. This is something that I kind of noticed quite heavily, because the story doesn't really have much of a climax. This is something a lot of other people mentioned as well about the mod on Planet Philip and elsewhere. And it is kind of a problem. It kind of sets up this big expectation in the player's mind when they first start. They see all these story sequences. We'll see some cutscenes coming up fairly soon. We can talk more about them as they appear, but you kind of get this feeling that it's going to all come to a head and, you know, everything's going to be revealed and there's going to be some nice bit of closure at the end. And it never really happens. I mean, it's all kind of left open, which in some respects is probably quite nice. I'm sure some people maybe enjoyed that. They can kind of draw their own conclusions about what's actually happening here. But I kind of felt that it was kind of left a little bit too open, like even kind of basic questions I had about the story were kind of left unanswered. I mean, stuff like whether the player is actually crazy and all this kind of stuff that we can go into later on, is something I wouldn't really have minded kind of being left to the player to kind of work out by themselves. But kind of basic questions like, what is this island that they're on, this island trapped in this sphere that you can see in the sky, like, what's that all about? And it's never really explained anywhere. That's something I really wish you'd been given something, like either tell something about the player or something about the environment, just to have something to grab onto, like, okay, I understand more now. And that would have been really nice, but unfortunately it just doesn't happen. Yeah, so spoilers. I suppose it's a little bit late now, but hey, this isn't a review, it's more of a commentary, so I'm sure you've all played this by now anyway. So let's talk about what we've seen so far, really. The level design is really, really nice. There's some nice detail everywhere, everything's fairly polished. This area we're exploring right now, I think, does suffer a bit from locked door syndrome and kind of identical corridor syndrome as well, to an extent. A lot of these areas here do look very, very similar, and I did get a bit lost around here on my first time through the mod, unfortunately. Here's where we get our first real kind of puzzle area. In the corridor behind me, there's these kind of fixtures on the wall which house the gravity gun. And they've kind of got these very 80s style kind of giant keycard things that you can slot in to open them up. It's a really nice, kind of harkens back to kind of the days of Quake as well. You kind of pick up these giant keycards and it's very, very cool. So here you can see I found one of them. What I would have really loved is to So have lots of these kind of random, have lots of different things you could open up with them. As it stands, they're just kind of used here and then you never see them again, which is a real shame. It looks like a really cool mechanic you could have used throughout the entire mod to, you know, open up different things. One little neat piece of presentation I did like is that as you walk up here and you see them, there's a keycard already in the center terminal here, so it kind of just shows the player that, you know, what they're looking for is a keycard in order to open up these doors. And then you've got the kind of red and green on-off lights as well, just to reinforce that that's what they're for. Which is nice. I mean, I didn't get confused by this at all. I saw the keycard in the machine and I knew that I had to find another one to open up the gravity gun terminal. So that was a nice bit of presentation. But yeah, I just think it's perhaps a bit of a missed opportunity. It would have been nice to have this mechanic explored throughout the entire mod. Using keycards to power up different things. Now at this point, for some reason I thought it would be fun to backtrack through half the level just to check if I'd missed anything, so we'll skip past all that because there was nothing there. Now another thing I wasn't too fond of with this particular mod in the beginning is that I feel the pacing at the beginning is perhaps just a tad too slow, for my tastes anyway. It feels like it takes a really long time to actually get into any real combat. Spend a really long time just kind of exploring through this kind of empty complex with just a crowbar and a gravity gun. And I feel like there's not really enough kind of puzzle solving or interesting gameplay to really justify the amount of time you spend like this. It's just a shame because once the combat does start, the quality picks up dramatically. In fact, the combat setups and kind of layouts and things that David uses in this map is one of my favourite parts of it. I thought the combat encounters were absolutely fantastic. It's just a shame it takes so long to get there. It's kind of this giant void where you're just kind of walking around this empty base. And again, perhaps some stronger story elements could help here. But yeah, I just feel like there's too much kind of... I hesitate to call it filler, but I just think the pacing is just slightly wrong at the beginning here. There's too much just walking around, nothing really happening. Find ourselves a pistol there on the floor. I moan about this a lot in mods actually, but I kind of dislike it when you just kind of randomly pick up a weapon with no kind of rhyme or reason to it. I mean, you just kind of walk into this room and, oh look, a pistol on the floor. Why? Why is it there? I mean, you don't even really need to shoot anything for a long time. So it's just kind of strange that you get a pistol right now and there's nothing really, there's no real enemies yet to fight. There's nothing really to shoot, to kind of activate any puzzles or anything. Just feels kind of random in a way. So here's where you get your kind of first taste that things aren't quite what they appear. And something really subtle like this in the skybox is really interesting. Because it's something that you might not have even noticed at first glance, it just kind of looks like a normal day. You know, but when you kind of squint and look up at the sky, perhaps wait for the HDR to adjust a bit, you kind of notice that you're in this giant sphere. It's suddenly like, whoa, what is actually going on here? And now we start getting these really interesting kind of, I guess they're flashbacks? It's slightly ambiguous as to what you're actually seeing, whether they're kind of flashbacks from something you've seen before, whether they're someone else's memories, or whether you're just kind of some sort of psychic connection. I'm not actually sure what's going on. Again, it kind of loops back to the story being fairly loose with its explanations. little bit of chess, why not? Yeah, kind of all these story sequences are kind of lumped in all together, all at once. And again, it's kind of another pacing issue where I kind of wish these kind of flashbacks were more spaced apart, so you'd have kind of like a puzzle area and then perhaps a flashback, and then you'd have more puzzle or some combat and then another flashback. As it is now, you're kind of walking around, you have three or four flashbacks all at once, and then the mod kind of shifts back into standard gameplay mode. Kind of a bit of a jarring transition there, I think, between the two. I feel like it could have been spliced together a bit better, perhaps. Yeah, my own kind of interpretation of these is that it is kind of flashback, like you're seeing something that happened before, whether through your own mind or through someone else's, I'm not quite sure, but it feels like you are kind of looking back at the past. Yay, finally we can kill something! Some nice atmosphere in this section. And kind of all the way through the mod, there's some nice use of kind of soundscapes and ambience and things like that. The levels do feel fairly alive. Like getting a decent soundscape and decent ambience in the maps is so important. And I see this time and time again. People just they either use no ambience at all, or they kind of throw so many sounds and things all over the place that it just becomes a cacophony of noise. Just finding the right mix of kind of audio for your maps. It should never be completely silent unless that's kind of exactly what you want at that moment, you know, for a pacing or story reason, or to build some sort of suspense before a big stab or something. But yeah, that's one of the most common complaints I have about building atmosphere in maps, is that people just they don't take into account just how powerful audio can be with immersion and kind of just bringing the world to life. Because generally game worlds they're really, really static, generally. Like this map, there's basically hardly any moving parts that we've seen so far. There's a couple of physics props you can move around, but essentially everything doesn't move. This isn't just in this mod, it's in kind of source maps in general, kind of even just game maps in general. They're kind of very, very static, and audio is one of the things you can use to kind of bring life to it. Even if things aren't really moving, you can give it a sense of movement just with the sound you use. I really enjoy kind of taking perhaps a room I've made or an entire area or something, and just doing like just focusing completely on playing through the area and deciding what kind of sounds I want in different areas, what would feel natural in all these different spaces. And then it can be really fun kind of going through and placing all the soundscapes and, you know, ambient entities and everything like that. It's a really important process. Level designer says no, you cannot have these shiny items. I don't think I actually found the solution to that in this playthrough, but there is actually a vent hidden behind some props in this area that you can get around into that room and pick up those items. Thank you. it's a hole in one. So I think this is a kind of another case of kind of finding the solution before you see the problem. So you kind of see the steam coming out of the pipe, but you don't actually know that you have to climb onto the pipe until you've already used the wheel to turn off the steam. I think it could have been paced better where perhaps the steam was actually around here. And you'd kind of jump on the pipe, go around the corner, see the steam, and think, ah. And then you'd have to find a wheel somewhere else to turn it off, so you actually understand that the steam is actually blocking your progress before you actually find a wheel to turn it off. Seems like it'd be a bit more logical to me in that kind of order. Get a nice little bit of vista. Again, notice the spherical sky. Padlocks, good, good, good. My pet peeve, I know. Got ourselves a shotgun now. The shotgun pickup feels a bit better than the pistol one because you're actually breaking into like a security office to get it. It makes a bit more sense. It wasn't just kind of lying on the floor in our path like the pistol was. Unfortunately, Harry the Gnome is immovable in this mod, so automatic 1 out of 10 there. I like how he reuses the pipe puzzle here and gets players into a rhythm of it. It would have been nice perhaps if he'd started out with just a basic pipe puzzle like that and then have the steam part of it added later as, you know, an added layer of complexity. Kind of feels backwards there, where you kind of have the most complex iteration of the puzzle at the beginning. Finally some fresh air. So I actually really like this area because you see kind of the monorail track up above and it gives you that feeling like, ooh, I wonder if I can ride that. Turns out we can a bit later on. Would have been nice if we perhaps saw a monorail go past as we exited to the outdoor section here. Now this one particular puzzle here is the only part of the mod I really didn't like. I'm talking specifically about the need to kind of shoot through the bars here and hit the terminal in order to open this door. It just doesn't feel natural. I mean, there's fairly decent kind of damage feedback that you're actually doing something by shooting. And I suppose you could argue that it's the only action that really makes sense after a while, because you can't actually do anything else. But it just didn't quite feel right for me. I can imagine a lot of people perhaps got a bit stuck here, maybe. Be interesting to hear what people think in the comments about this area. Because I myself, it took me a while to actually think, well, there's nothing else I can do. I guess I'll just try and shoot, and it ends up working. I was surprised that it did work. Let's just leave it that way. So I was kind of looking around here for a long time, trying to work out what to do. Trying to climb up the drain pipe. Yeah, so I did get a bit confused. You kind of see the green light behind the panel. I was trying to shoot the wire out of the socket, that wasn't working. So I just figured I'd shoot that and it actually breaks. But if the actual terminal hadn't sparked when you shoot it, I don't think I would have kept on shooting there. But just shows how important damage feedback can be in puzzles like that. Alright, I'll be back with part 2 soon.